Down in New Orleans, where the blues were born, it takes a cool cat to blow a horn. On the side and Rampart Street, the Cowboys play with
Mardi Gras, a time of festivity, celebration, and tradition for the people of New Orleans. This yearly event draws over 1 million visitors and is an integral component of the New Orleans culture.
Mardi Gras, which means Fat Tuesday, began to form when the Romans and the Catholic converters combined their spring celebrations in the 5th century. The celebrations on Fat Tuesday began to be referred to as Carnival, as it was the day to feast before Ash Wednesday, and when the 40-day long period of Lent began. The Catholics in France began to refer to the celebration as Mardi Gras, and over time, as Catholic popularity arose, Mardi Gras spread to the New World, and most famously, New Orleans. Many traditions began to be associated with Mardi Gras over the centuries, such as masked balls, Mardi Gras Indian, the colors green, gold, and purple, which stood for faith, power, and justice, Rex the official king of Mardi Gras, and perhaps most significantly, in 1837, parades. Mardi Gras has become a time of great celebration and fun, as it is always meant to be and will continue to be.
The food of Mardi Gras is highly unique, ranging from traditional New Orleans cuisine to extraordinary feats of engineering. The culinary aspects of Mardi Gras are sure to impress. Standard meals include etouffee, muffalettas, jambalaya, and various fried seafood dishes. The most important food of Mardi Gras is the traditional king cake. Similar to coffee cake, this brightly colored dessert contains a small plastic trinket inside. According to superstition, whoever finds the trinket is destined to have a year of good luck. The longest king cake ever built was an astounding 5,300 feet long and wrapped around the Superdome twice. While king cake is the signature dessert of Mardi Gras, Bananas Foster is also commonplace. Bananas Foster, which originated in the city of New Orleans, is made with ice cream and caramelized bananas.
One of the biggest parts about Mardi Gras is the dancing. The dancing tradition comes from the Native American population in New Orleans and is a spectacle every year. Each chief of each tribe must make a dress and a flag. These dresses and flags can be made out of anything the chief desires, but they must be made one piece at a time. When two chiefs meet, they dance for one another until the crowd is satisfied and they continue to walk on until they find another chief. This tradition is done every year and is done exclusively by the Native American population within their quarter of the city of New Orleans.
Music and Mardi Gras.
When New Orleans was founded, both the French and the Spanish enjoyed a vibrant carnival masked ball season with between 50 and 60 balls during the period between Twelfth Night in January and Ash Wednesday. Everyone in the city focused on dancing. The music of the carnival balls reflected the dance preferred by the attendees. Live bands played gavottes, quadrilles, minuets, reels, and many other European dances. The favorite carnival ball dance of the 1870 was the waltz. The music was hypnotic. Men and women hugged tightly to each other and swirled. The planned pageantry of each carnival ball was set to music. The royal entrance of the king and court, the performance of tableau, presentation of the court, the promenade, and the grand march all preceded dancing by the assembled guests. The song commonly used for the royal procession was Verdi's Grand March from the opera Idea. In 1872, George Lindbergh's song If Ever I Cease to Love was performed during Mardi Gras by British singer Lyta Thompson. It became the theme song for the ball of the crew of Rex, King of Carnival. It is still one of the most popular songs played in New Orleans during Mardi Gras. The multicultural nature of New Orleans blended music traditions from Native Americans, Africans, French, Spanish, and Caribbean Islanders. Congo Square was the communal gathering place for people of color. They celebrated with the call and response and strong drumming traditions seen among African natives. This musical style was popularized with the African American celebrants of Mardi Gras, including the war chants of the Indians, the call and response of the street walking baby dolls, and the jubilant brass band marches of the Zulus. In the late 1800s, over 100 brass bands played about New Orleans. from Mardi Gras, whites in costumes would hire African-American brass bands to ride in horse or mule-drawn carriages to accompany them as they reveled in the streets. Louis Armstrong popularized one song that became a Mardi Gras staple, When the Saints Go Marching In. Blending of these musical styles is still reflected in New Orleans' second-line funk rhythms. Many Mardi Gras classics have the 3-2 second-line beat pattern, popular in the songs like Ico Ico, which directly refers to the Mardi Gras Indians, the Meters hit Hey Pack Away, or Joe Avery's song Second Line. When one hears the rhythm, it is hard to not start moving to the beat. This cultural fusion totally captures the joy and vibrancy that is celebrated in New Orleans at Mardi Gras.
During the Mardi Gras Marathon, the streets of New Orleans are filled with music, food, costumes, alcohol, and dancing. The season includes both new and old traditions regarding the occasion. There are many parades and floats held to celebrate the holiday, and many are themed according to specific Mardi Gras traditions. For example, Indian parades in particular are known famously for their handcrafted costumes, many of which contain individually sewn-on beadwork and other elaborate intricacies. Larry Bannock, a New Orleanian Indian, recently wore a hand-beaded and feathered suit that he himself designed, which weighed over 100 pounds, to a parade. This is only one, however, of many in his collection. As Bannock informs readers, a new costume is created each year, as is the Indian Mardi Gras tradition. This is one of many traditions that make the holiday unique to New Orleans.
Think you know your Mardi Gras statistics? Let's find out. Did you know that 1.2 million people attended last year's Mardi Gras Festival, which is roughly the population of Swaziland? Or how about that the city of New Orleans spends $3.33 million on Mardi Gras each year, and sees a return of $4.48 for every public dollar spent? Hotels even take in $56 million during the 12 days of Mardi Gras. Alcohol sales topped $2.6 million, and 1,278 businesses were permitted to sell alcohol, 15 of which were issued citations for various infractions. In one instance, 97 kegs of beer were confiscated from a single frat party. 118 state troopers were sent to maintain order in the French quarters. The festival has its own unique set of vocabulary, and 7 out of 10 Americans are in favor of making Mardi Gras a national holiday. The Backstreet Cultural Museum is dedicated towards the preservation of the Mardi Gras Indian way of life. Dozens of brilliantly decorated costumes from throughout the city's history are housed inside. We were able to interview the founder and visionary behind the museum. Here's what he has to say.
It takes a year, it takes 4 or 5 people to make one suit. Now, this one suit, we use it only 3 times. Carnival Day is the first time. March the 19th is the second time. Then the Sunday after March the 19th, Super Sunday. That's the third time.
Well, you get down the fiddle and you get down the bow. Kick off your shoes and you throw them on the floor. Dance in the kitchen till the morning light. Louisiana Saturday night. Waiting in the front yard, sitting on a log. A single-shot rifle and a one-eyed dog. Yonder come our kinfolk in the moonlight. Louisiana Saturday night. Well, you get down the fiddle and you get down the bow. Kick off your shoes and you throw them in the floor. Dance in the kitchen till the morning light, Louisiana Saturday night. My brother Bill and my other brother Jack, belly full of beer and a possum in a sack. 15 kids in the front porch light, Louisiana Saturday night.